To start the lecture series of Mathematics 1, and today topic is Fourier series part 2. In last session we are discussed about the Fourier series part 1. In that case we are study about the Fourier series in the interval 0 to 2L. So now today we are start the Fourier series in the interval minus L to L. So the formula of the Fourier series in the interval minus L to L, that is f of x equal to a 0 by 2 plus summation n equal to 1 to infinite a n cos n by x by l plus b n sin n by x by l, where a 0 a n b n r. So a 0 1 upon l integration minus l to l f of x dx, and a n 1 by l integration minus l to l f of x cos n by x by l dx, and b n is 1 by l integration minus l to l sin f of x sin n by x by l dx. So this is the formula of the a 0 a n and b n. Knowledge about the even function and odd function. So first, what is the even function? Even function is f of minus x equal to f of x. So that means if any function, if we are replacing minus x with x and we are getting same function, so function is even. Function is even, then in integration, if it is symmetric interval like minus a to a and function is even, so we are getting 2 0 to a f of x dx. Example as x square, x raised to 4, x raised to 6 and cos x, all are even function which is a symmetric with the y axis. See, in this graph of even function is, we are taking a graph of mod x, both axes, there is a positive value and negative value, positive value function, negative value functions. See, here, there are same type of the value. If we are replacing f of x and f of minus x, we are getting same function. So this is a even function and this is a symmetric with the y axis. Okay, so this is a even function. Now we are studying about the odd function. What is the odd? If f of minus x equal to minus f of x. In that case, in the integration, if minus a to a f of x dx, then f of x is odd, answer is 0. Example of the odd function is x, x cube, x raised to 5 up to it, and sin nx is also odd function. See in this graph, this is the graph of f of x equal to x. X is the odd function. For the positive value of x, this is the negative value of x, positive value of f of x, positive value of f of minus x. See in this graph, we are getting different forms of the graph. So this is the odd function. And it is a start with the origin and symmetric with the origin form. See, this is the origin. Okay. So this is an even and odd function. Now Fourier series for the even function, let f of x be a periodic function minus L to L. And f of x is even, so mean equal to 0. Because in mean term we are getting sin term. Sin is odd function. So bn is 0. So we have only two terms, that is a0 and an. So formula is f of x equal to a0 by 2 plus summation n equal to 1 to infinite an cos n by x by l, where a0 and an are 2 by l. Why 2 by l? In that case, a0 and an are even function. For the even function, in the integration, we are divide the interval and multiply with the 2. So a0 equal to 2 by l 0 to l f of x dx, and an equal to 2 by l 0 to l integration f of x cos n by x by l dx. Okay. Now Fourier series for the odd function. In that case, a0 and an are 0. So function is summation n equal to 1 to infinite bn sin n by x by l. Because in that case, bn have sine function. This is the odd function. So we are getting it the even one. So mu n equal to 2 by L 0 to L f of x sine n pi x by L dx. So this is the formula of even function and odd function. So now we are start with the example 1. Find the Fourier series of the periodic function f of x equal to 2x. 2x, if x is odd, then 2x is also odd and interval is minus 1 to 1. So what is our L? It is 1. The given function is odd and it is defined by symmetric interval. So this is a odd function and it is solved by this formula f of x equal to n equal to 1 to infinite bn sine n pi x by L. What is a bn? Bn is 2 by L 0 to L f of x sine n pi x by L dx. What is L? L is 1. So we are getting 2 by 1 integration 0 to 1 f of x. What is f of x? 2x and sine n pi x by L. What is L? L is 1. So we are getting 2x sine n pi x dx. Okay. Integrate this, we are taking 2 in the outside of the integration. So it is 4, 0 to 1 integration x sine n pi x dx. So again Leibniz rule, x u as it is, integration of sine n pi x minus cos n pi x by n pi, differentiation of x is 1 and integration of minus cos n pi x is minus sine n pi x by n pi square. And using Leibniz rule, we are getting alternate sign, so it is minus. So if we are putting upper limit, if we are putting upper limit 1, that is we are getting a 1 minus cos n pi upon n pi. And if in putting in the sin n pi, x equal to 1, it is 0, sin 0, 0. So we are getting only minus 4 cos n pi upon n pi. But the cos n pi is minus 1 raised to n and all minus sign. So we are getting 4 minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n pi. Hence, the Fourier series of the f of x is given by substituting the value of bn. So answer is f of x summation n equal to 1 to infinite 4 minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n pi sine n pi x. So this is our last answer of the f of x. For the function 2x and the interval is minus 1 to 1. Okay. Now, next example. Find the Fourier series for the f of x equal to x square in minus L to L. We have the series minus L to L. So, L equal to L. F of x minus x equal to f of x. It is even function. If it is even function, then we have the formula f of x equal to a0 by 2 plus summation n equal to 1 to infinite a n cos n pi x by L. Now, what is a0? A0 is 2 by L integration 0 to L f of x dx. So, 2 by L, what is our capital L? It is small l. And integration 0 to small l x square dx. Integration is x cube by 3. Upper limit L, lower limit 0. Putting the upper limit and lower limit, we getting A0 equal to 2L square by 3. Now, for the AN, formula is 2 by L, 0 to L, f of x cos n pi x by L dx equal to 2 by small l integration 0 to small l x square. What is the function? X square. So, cos n pi x by L dx. Again, Leibniz rule. 2 by L as it is, then we are taking x square equal to u and cos equal to v. So x square integration of cos, that is sine n pi x by L into L by n pi. Differentiation of x square is minus 2x. And integration of sine n pi x by L is again minus cos n pi x by L into L by n pi whole square. After that, differentiation of 2x. U term 2x is 2, see, okay. So 2 and integration of minus sine n pi x by L, L upon n pi whole cube 0 to L. So this is a whole integration using Leibniz rule. Now, sine 0 is 0 and sine n pi is 0, okay. So lower limit is 0. In the upper limit, we are getting only middle term because of If we are putting the sign 2 n pi, it is 0 for the upper limit. So for the middle term, we are getting 2 by L, 2 L, L upon n pi whole square cos n pi. But cos n pi is minus 1 raised to n. So a n is 4 L square minus 1 raised to n upon n pi whole square. Okay. So for the Fourier series for this function, a 0 by 2 plus summation n equal to 1 to infinite a n cos n pi x upon L. Substitute the a 0 and a n. If we are substituting a 0 a n, then we are getting f of x L square by 3, because we have a 0 to L square by 3. So 2 to cut. So in the a 0 term, we are getting L square by 3 plus we are replacing a n value and cos n pi x by L as it is. So this is our Fourier series or for the function of x square, and the interval is minus L to L. Next example. See, in this case, in this function, we are taking x plus x square, where x is odd function and x square is even function. Is the necessary condition, if we are conducting the odd and even, if we are conclude the function is even or odd, then interval is compulsory, it is symmetric formation, like minus a to a form. If it is in 0 to a form, then function is not odd, not even. So we are taking find Fourier series f of x equal to x plus x square, where minus 2 to 2. In that case, this is not the either even or odd. So we are taking a 0, 1 by L minus L to L f of x dx is the simple form, equal to 1 by 2 integration minus 2 to 2 x plus x square dx. Now we are separating this 1 by 2 minus 2 to 2 x dx plus 1 by 2 minus 2 to 2 integration x square dx. Now in that case, first term 1 by 2 minus 2 to 2 x dx is odd. So that is the value 0. And in the second term, 1 by 2 minus 2 to 2 x square dx, where x square is even function. So we are divide the interval and multiply with the 2. See, first term is 0, 2 by 2 integration 0 to 2 x square dx. Okay, then integrate this x cube by 3 upper limit minus lower limit. We are getting a 0 value 8 by 3. Okay, now an 1 by L integration minus L to L f of x cos n pi x by L dx. Again 1 by 2 integration minus 2 to 2 function x plus x square cos n pi x upon 2. What is L? L is 2. So n pi x by 2 dx. Okay. So see here, in separating this 1 by 2 integration minus 2 to 2 x cos n pi x by 2 dx plus 1 by 2 integration minus 2 to 2 x square cos n pi x by 2 dx. In that case, again first term is 0, because x is odd function and cos is even function. Even into odd is odd function. So we are getting this first term is 0 and second term solve by even term. So we are multiplying with the 2 and divide the interval 0 to 2. So we are getting 2 by 2 0 to 2 x square cos n pi x by 2 dx. Now integrate this by Leibniz rule. So Leibniz rule, u term x square as it is, integration of cos sin n pi x by 2 2 by n pi minus alternating series minus differentiation of x square is 2x cos n pi x by 2 4 upon n square plus again differentiation of u, that is 2, and again integration of v, that is minus sine n pi x by 2 8 upon n cube pi cube 0 to 2. Now putting upper limit minus lower limit in the first term. See, in this case, in first term, if we are putting 2, function is 0 because sine 2 n pi is 0. Again, in second term, if we are putting x equal to 2, we getting 4 minus 1 raised to n upon n square pi square 4 upon n square pi square, because in that case, if cos n pi 2, then 2 to cut, we are getting only minus cos n pi. In third term, if we are putting x equal to 2, we are getting 0 because sin n pi. Lower limit 0 because x square, if we are multiplying with the x, that is 0. again second term is 0 and third term is sine 0, 0. So we are getting last answer is 4 minus 1 raised to n upon n square pi square into 4 upon n square pi square. So we are taking 16 minus 1 raised to n upon n square pi square. Okay. Now, for the Vn, 1 by L minus L to L f of x sine n pi x by L dx. 1 by 2, integration minus 2 to 2, function is x plus x square sine n pi x by 2 dx. Again, separating this, 1 by 2 minus 2 to 2 x sine n pi x by 2 dx. 1 by 2, integration minus 2 to 2 x square sine n pi x by 2 dx. Here, in first term, x is odd and sine is odd. So, odd into odd is an even function. So, we are getting first term as an even. And same the second term, x square is even and sine is odd. So, in that case, second term is 0. See. So, first term, we are solved by even function. So, multiplying with the 2 and half the interval, we are taking 2 by 2, 0 to 2, x sine n pi x by 2, and in the second term, it is 0. Solve this using Leibniz rule. X as it is, integration of sine is minus cos n pi x by 2 into 2 upon n pi. Again, the Leibniz rule minus, and differentiation of x is 1, so we are getting minus sine n pi x by 2 into 4 upon n square pi square. Taking upper limit minus lower limit, we get 4 minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n pi is the answer of Bn. Okay. Next example. Obtain the Fourier series for the x square in the interval minus pi to pi and reduce that these two terms. Now, we are studying about the Fourier series of the minus L to L. Also, if we have to prove some type of the specific term. So, solve this example as a Fourier series normal example, and after the getting the function as the term of the Fourier series, we are taking the particular point to deduce two results. Now, for this function, x square is a even function, so mean is 0, L equal to pi. Okay, so what is a 0? 1 by L minus L to L f of x dx, but function is even, so we are getting 2 by L. What is L? Pi. So, 2 upon pi integration 0 to pi x square dx. Integrate this, we getting 2 pi square by 3. For the an, 1 by L integration minus L to L f of x cos n pi x by L dx. L is pi. So, we getting 2 by L 0 to L f of x cos n pi x by L dx. So, this is a 2 upon pi x square cos nx dx. Solve this using Leibniz rule. X square as it is, integration of cos is sine nx by n, then minus differentiation of x square, it is 2x, again integration of sine nx, it is minus cos nx, plus differentiation of 2x is 2, again integration of minus cos nx is minus sine nx upon n cube, and interval is 0 to pi. Taking upper limit minus lower limit, we are getting 2 pi minus 1 raised to n upon n square, and all term are 0 due to sine 0, 0 and sine n pi 0. So, last answer is 4 minus 1 raised to n upon n square. Put those term a 0 and a n in the function. So, we get f of x equal to pi square by 3, 4 minus 1 raised to n upon n square cos nx. This is our Fourier series function. Okay. Now, we have to deduce the sum result. In that case, we are taking the minus pi to pi interval. So, we are taking the x equal to pi at the end point. To deduce this result, we are taking x equal to pi in f of x. If f of x equal to pi square by 3 plus summation n equal to 1 to infinity 4 minus 1 raised to n upon n square cos nx. So, f of pi, because x equal to pi, pi square by 3 as it is, plus 4 summation n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n n square cos n pi. Cos nx is replaced by cos n pi. Now, what is cos n pi? It is minus 1 raised to n. So, we taking and f of pi. What is f of pi? f of x is x square. So what is f of pi? F of pi is pi square. And taking pi square by 3 in the left side, we are getting pi square minus pi square by 3 equal to 4 minus 1 raised to n upon n square into minus 1 raised to n. So this is a 2 pi square by 12 equal to 1 upon n square, because minus 1 raised to n into minus 1 raised to n, it is an even term. So we are taking 1 by n square in the right side. So last answer is summation n equal to 1 to infinite 1 upon n square equal to pi square by 6. So this is a result. Now for the second result, we are taking x equal to 0. First we are taking end point x equal to pi. Now we are taking the discontinuity point. What is the discontinuity point for the minus pi to pi? It is 0. So we are taking x equal to 0 in the f of x equal to pi square by 3 plus summation n equal to 1 to infinite 4 minus 1 raised to n upon n square cos nx. Taking this, then left hand side is 0. We are taking pi square by 3 in the left side and cos 0 is 1. So we are getting minus pi square by 12 summation n equal to 1 to infinite minus 1 raised to n upon n square. So we are taking minus sign in the right side. So we are getting minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n square equal to pi square by 12. So this is the two type of the result using the particular point or discontinuous point. Now next example is for the mod x formation. Find the Fourier series x plus mod x where interval is minus pi to pi. Okay. So what is L? L equal to pi. Here a0 equal to 1 by L integration minus L to L f of x dx. So equal to, we are taking 1 upon pi minus pi to pi x plus mod x dx. Now in that case, we are separating this 1 upon pi integration minus pi to pi x dx plus 1 upon pi integration minus pi to pi mod x dx. In that case, first term is 0 because x is odd function and interval is symmetric, like minus pi to pi. X is odd and mod x is even function. So this, in that case, in the second term, we are solved using the even term 2 upon pi 0 to pi x dx. So we getting the whole answer is a0 equal to pi. Clear? Now for the an, 1 by l c2 c plus 2l f of x cos n pi x by l dx 1 upon pi minus pi to pi. What is the function? X plus mod x. L equal to pi. So we getting cos nx dx. Now separating this 1 upon pi minus pi to pi x cos nx dx plus 1 upon pi minus pi to pi mod x cos nx dx. Okay. Now in the first term, x is odd and cos is even. Odd into even, even. And odd function. So mod x cos nx and even function. We getting only first term is 0 and getting second term is as a even formation. So 2 upon pi 0 to pi x cos nx dx. Okay. Now solve this by the Leibniz rule. As it is, 2 upon pi as it is, x as it is, u cos is v, x sin nx by n, differentiation of x is 1, and minus, for the Leibniz rule, minus cos nx upon n square 0 to pi. Upper limit minus lower limit, we are getting 2 upon pi minus 1 raised to n minus 1 upon n square is the answer of a. Bn equal to 1 upon L minus L to L f of x sin n pi x by L dx. So 1 upon pi minus pi to pi function is x plus mod x sin nx dx. Now separating this 1 upon pi minus pi to pi x sin nx dx plus 1 upon pi minus pi to pi mod x sin nx dx. In that case, x and x is odd, sin is odd. So first term is even and second term is odd because of mod x is even and sin is odd. Mod x even, sin is odd, even into odd, odd. So second term is odd and first term is even. So we getting second term 0 and first term solved by even form. 2 upon pi, range is half 0 to pi, sin x sin nx dx using Leibniz rule. 2 upon pi, x minus cos nx upon n minus sin nx by n square 0 to pi. Hold this answer, we getting 2 minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n. So last answer is f of x equal to a 0 by 2 plus summation n equal to 1 to infinite a n cos n pi x by l plus b n sin n pi x by l. We are replacing a 0, a n and b n, getting function equal to x plus mod x equal to pi by 2 summation, taking a n 2 upon pi minus 1 raised to n minus 1 upon n square cos n x plus b n as 2 minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n sin n. So in next lecture, we are discuss about the half range cosine series and half range sine series.